My name's Joshua Balderson, and this is the Hockey Nation. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Joshua here in Gananoque at the Lou Jeffries Memorial Arena. We have about 7 minutes left up on the scoreboard here. Zamboni's just pulling off the ice, so the referees and teams are going to be coming here in a moment. This is game two of the EOSHL finals between the North Dundas Rockets and the Gananoque Islanders. North Dundas right now is sitting with the one game series lead. They got 1-0. They did win last night in North Dundas. Looking to get a second win here and take it back home and finish it in three. They did win the first two seasons they played in this. They faced Gananoque in the finals. Both times, North Dundas walked away with the victory, winning the EOSHL championship. So we'll see here. Gananoque wants to stop that, but they have had a hard time being able to do that so far this in their life in the USHL, as they haven't been able to get past the finals and win it. So we'll see here. Tonight's a big game. They have to win at home if they're going to want to go and have a chance of stealing one in North Dundas. And then coming back here and winning at home. I don't need the sunglasses. We're inside and they're distracting me. So I'm just killing some time here. You see lots of fans. This place punched right now. Sold out crowd. I'm almost positive. There's no seats anywhere. So tons of people walking around. You're not here. You're checking this game out live. So I'm going to pop us over here. We got the setup on the Gananoque Islanders dressing room door. There are a couple things to go over in the lineup today. You will notice number 33, Dallas Slack. Now, for those of you that may have saw the game sheet, like myself, wondered, what is Dallas Slack doing on there? That must be an input error. It was not. Dallas Slack is playing. He was here in the warm-up getting ready to go, so he's going to be backing up, I believe. Might be starting. Who knows? But we got Leif Hertz and Dallas Slack as the goalie tandem here tonight. Players for Gananoque is going to be Sean Dixon, Chad Duchesne, Jack Wiley, Alex Reese, Graham Brown, Chris Latimer, Justin Stevens, Aiden Harris, Kevin Domingo, Braden Mercer, Ben Blasco, Ryan Palakowski, Wyatt Cota, Cole Bouchard, Eric Selleck, Ryan Rubik, Cody Smith, and Brock Higgs. That's what we got for a lineup here from the Islanders. As the North Dundas Rockets, I'll probably screw up a bunch of these names. We have Peter Mott, Sean Moores, Brody Belanger, Chris Kuznick, Derek Froats, Matt Cowley, Cameron Conton, Michael McNamee, Adam Bebridge, Bradley Stitt, Fabian Walsh, Brett Gustafson, Doug Harvey, Craig Baxter, Todd Markellis, Tanner Williams, and Andrew Rajinovic. In net, we're pretty sure going starting up tonight is going to be number 25, Matt Jenkins. He has had an amazing season, and he has been the star player. He should get MVP of the USHL season, as the way he's been playing this season, causing mayhem for the other teams. Backing up, we have Maxime Bouger. Will be in the backup role. So I've had ideas. Just cutting down time here. We started up. We don't want to miss a minute of the action. So we hope you're ready to go here again. Sold out crowd here in Gananoque for this game. Gananoque will be in the gray jerseys with the green. And the Rockets will be in the maroon and cream colored jerseys. It is a loud one in this arena. Tons of fans, tons of people just right, ready, excited. Gananoque has been playing a less physical game here this season in the playoffs for sure. So we expect to see that to continue. They might be going back to their old ways a little bit, trying to throw off the Rockets because they have not been as physical as they used to be. But we'll see what happens. Game last night in Chesterville, 5-4 for the Rockets. Apologize for my camera people. There's a lot of people in here today and they are bumping into my gear, so if things come off of their alignment, that I do apologize. I've been trying to walk around as politely that people give a little distance between my gear, but they have not been listening and just coming by and doing whatever. So I do apologize. Best of luck to us this game, that nothing gets bumped off. The score clock camera is a little bit finicky over there on that tripod. That seems to be one that moves the most. So again, back to 5-4 was the game. 1-1 was it, score after one. Then 5-2 was the score after two. And then Gannock was able to putt two in the third, but unable to get that third one tied up, making it 5-4. Gannock had 50 shots and only four goals, so 46 saves for Jenkins. Fabian Walsh got the first star, 2 goals, 1 assist, 3 points. Michael Mahaney got the second star with 3 assists, and Brock King took the third star with 2 goals and an assist in that game. Only notable penalty was a checking from behind, 2:10, served Eric Selk with 2:40 left in the third period. That's pretty much all we have on the game. As we get ready here for puck drop, you can see door opening for the Gannock Way change room, and we have the door open on the ice. Refs on the ice, Rockets on the ice. Where are the Gannock Way Islanders? And now here they come. They are being led by number one, Leif Hertz. So it looks like Leif Hertz will be getting the start here tonight for the Islanders. With Slack backing up. 30 seconds on the clock as the Islanders are making their entrance. See there in the green pads, Dallas Slack. Smith Falls goaltender. Looks to be maybe an emergency trade here in the playoffs to bring him up. You do know Jake Kmet has been playing some with the Wolves. It's about time for puck drop. As you can hear the crowd giving a chant for Let's Go Rockets, Gannock Rays fans have not responded. As you can tell, they're on the edge of their seats. As they've been in this position before, the past 2 years prior, about the same outcome. We'll see here as the puck gets ready to drop here. Kevin Domingo coming in, setting up across from McNamee. Face off one back into Gananoque's zone as the Islanders will put up along the far side. Gets banged up there at the score box as it's picked up by Kucherov and brought back into his own zone. Driving out, pulls it in, gets over to center, shoots it on to Hertz. And then we get grabbed up quickly by Brown, who will chip it off the glass, but a good play there by McNamee. Gets that puck, bat in deep in behind the net. Centering opportunity, couldn't connect with anybody as Gananoque grabs that puck up, and they get it to Selig, who chips it in, and will chase on down to Jenkins, giving a little shove there on the D. Trying to start a little bit of the rough stuff up here as Rockets get that puck, driving it down here along in close, sent it in on to Hertz. Hertz stops up, leaves it for his D as he'll get picked up here by Gananoque. Duchesne sent up to this close side, then sent in for opportunity for Higgs. Shot, and then the rebound. Chopped just over top of the net as Brown has it in. Now dropped in. Palkowski puts it backward to Higgs. Higgs back to the point. Duchesne shoots, and a good stick there by Froats. Breaks that one up as he'll bring it back out of the zone. Sends it over. Coming in. Chip play. Just misses the net as it comes off this close corner. Back to the point. Mott sends it right back in, but then it gets grabbed up by the stick of Duchesne, tipped right onto net. Leapers will stop that one up. So a minute 19 killed down here in the first period as both these two teams are going to look to try to figure each other out. What do they need to do tonight to get this one through? Puck one over to the sideboards, back to the point. They get by, chip down, racing in, stops up, and a poke on to Domingo, gets that one off of his stick, but we have a penalty call coming. As Peter Mott goes to the penalty box at the 18:32 mark. 2 minutes up on the board. Gananoque is going to get their chance here on the power play for the first time tonight. That's 2 minutes for ice sticking. Puck on the sideboards, battling. Chip before Duchesne, you get a stick on it and all the way down. Too far for Hurst to reach. So Higgs will pick that one up and take it in behind his net. Stops up, waiting for some support as he'll carry it off to the far side of the net. Chips up to the far side boards at center. Driving it in, they chip it at the blue line, kept and gets in, chipped around the boards by Selick as it goes over, and a big hit there laid by Beveridge. Didn't knock the Gananoque player off his feet, but definitely took the impact on that one as there was a whistle, and that puck is going to come just to the right of Jenkins in deep as Blasco comes in for Gananoque to set up on this faceoff. Dot goes up against McNamee, one back by Blasco to the point on the stick of Duchesne to the sideboard. Center front, chip puck bouncing. Couldn't get that one to settle down. And that one comes out of the zone and goes all the way down the ice. He'll get stopped up by Hertz and spun around the backside. Chipped over to Higgs. Higgs has it. Chips up to center ice. Now here comes a drive for Blasco. Drop pass. Tries to get that puck back to him, but it goes off into the corner. As a drive there, Selick tries to lay a big hit. Goes off his feet. The shot got into the net. Puck in behind. Verbeek tries to chip it out, but it hits a leg. Back to the point. Down on his knees was Duchesne, but still able to keep that in on the stick of Blasco. Now down low to Verbeek. Sends over to the far side. Can't connect with Higgs as it comes out onto the stick of Duchesne, who wraps it around to Blasco on his close boards. Gets off to Selick. Selick trying to cut in. Trailing in behind was Blasco, who's going to get it over in the corner and chip it in behind the net. Around past Selick to the point to Higgs. Higgs chips it back past by Selick in behind the net, but grabbed up quickly by Moores as he sends it to the point and is able to get out as Duchesne will come back. Chip it over to this close side to Verbeek. Verbeek can't get it through as now here comes a drive, but they can't get in. Duchesne turns it back the other way, trying to connect with a drive, couldn't get it, and now it's going to come down to the blue line as Brown tries to throw a check, but it was dodged quickly. Reimer is Marcellus now driven out of the zone. Here comes Domingo in over center, holding shot. Can't get that one to connect to the net as it goes just high. Picked up on Gann's stick. They try to center it, and it goes up and out of play for a whistle at 16-24. Penalty to Mott is over as we're back on 5-on-5 action. Shots on the board right now are 2-2. As we play down 3 minutes, 36 seconds. Face off in the corner, in front of the net. Picked up, taken in behind, driven up this close boards. As they're gonna try to get down. Good stop play there by Palakowski. Couldn't get that one to settle down, chipped in deep. And back to the point, in far side. Looking to get a drive. Good play there by the D. Keeps it, but then Dixon fires it out and is going to go down the ice for icing, stopping the play. You'll see some of those sponsors down on the bottom of the screen right now. And right now, Gustafson comes into that faceoff to be of Domingo. Takes Domingo off his feet. One by the Rockets, shot on to Hertz. And there was definitely a missed call as Gustafson got his stick caught up in the leg of Domingo and pulled him down. As you can hear, again, Aquay's coach Tom Dixon giving it to the officials. He's not happy. That was a missed call. We'll have to get used to that. That does happen here in the USHL a fair amount. As they're going to reset here to the left of Hertz. 15-54 on the board. Higgs comes in across from Gustafson. Oh, Kevin Domingue gets a penalty out of this. How does he get a penalty getting pulled down with ice sticking? Potentially got him with a stick going down, but definitely was a trip on the play. So again, Aquay shorthanded. That's probably the reason Dixon was getting so irate with the official, as he got a penalty when he should have been going with his team on a power play. Puck comes out of the zone. Here comes North Dundas drive in. Krzyzniak drops that puck off. Shot! And a good save made by Hertz as it gets fired out of the zone and all the way down the ice, stopped up by Jenkins and left for his defense. As here, they'll drive that puck out, back in as Gann Aquay is playing defensive here on this penalty kill, but a good job there. Breaks that puck up, sends it right back out, and he'll get chased down by Moores. In behind his net he goes with the puck as he'll start the drive out. As a little bit of pressure coming from Selick. Gann Aquay changing up their strategy. Quick on the puck, chips it out, down. It'll be stopped up again. Gann Aquay is killed down. A minute five into their penalty, keeping the Rockets far away from their net. Good play at the blue, scooped up by Reznak. Comes in, drag shot, leg save by Hertz. He's able to get back and keep that pad sealed down before they get a shot through. Still battling with that puck behind the net, sent back to the blue line. Back over into the sideboards, sent on the net. And that one hits the side of the net, stays out. As the crowd reacted to that one. Puck still along the boards. 20 seconds remaining on the penalty here too. Domingo shot and goes in off of the foot. And that's going to give the Rockets the lead they were looking for here in Gann to start this game off. 1-0 is a score on an awkward bounce off the D's foot, giving the Rockets the lead here. 1-0. Scored by number 27, Michael McNamee. Gann Aquay now down by one at 5 minutes and 51 seconds into the first period. McNamee unassisted. Now Gann Aquay down. We'll see, does this change their game plan at all? Are they going to continue to keep this pressure. You can see just some movement here down low. Again, Akwe continuing. We get that puck now on the Latimer stick as he sends that one up ice. Couldn't spring Smith as he was attempting to. Good bump there. And then you see another hit there as they're battling just in below the camera. They got up in close. They tried to send again. Smith couldn't get him. He's going to chase that puck in behind the net. Grabbed up as now out comes. That was Beveridge in that one. Got the crowd going. It almost makes its way in. Right on the corner looking. Centering opportunity. Back shot. Broke up just as it got its way to net. Now here comes a drive. Blasco stops up. Trying to get it by the D, but they got good coverage. They're able to fire it out to the other side. Now a drive here. Shot and a good save. Rebound and they score! Putting it by the Gananoque goalie. Now making it 2-0. And that's going to put North Dundas in a prime spot to get a good series lead here. Now Gananoque is going to have to figure something out to put this one back into a position where they can get back on the positive side of the scoreboard. They're not going Gananoque's way right now. The Rockets fans letting everybody know they're here as Harris comes in against Namie. Puck sent in, goes in. See Gananoque coming in with some speed there now, looking for a hit. Puck up and out of play off of the ceiling, netting. That play should be coming inside the zone here for North Dundas. It was cleared out from that zone. So that faceoff's gonna come to the right of Jenkins. Right now, visitors, North Dundas Rockets holding 6 shots to Gananoque's second. So Gananoque needs to get this puck to the point, but a turnover here in their zone is able for the Rockets to get out, trying to turn that one over now. But some great D at the blue line breaks that one out. Salah comes in with a little bit of a hit from the side, but no officials' arms go up as the crowd gave a little bit of a collective sigh. But no call coming their way in to where the bench is, causing some issues for Gananoque. That puck turned back now and sent in behind the net, stopped up by Hertz, left for Dixon. Dixon gets that puck off to the side boards before he can take a hit. And now, shift up ice, here comes Gananoque into the zone. Blasco gets that puck, pinched off over into the corner. He's gonna battle. He's gonna get back to the point. Brown shot just wide of the net as he's gonna come over. Stevens grabs that one up on his stick, sends it to the far side, can't get it. Call coming as Gananoque has the extra attacker out, as this will be going against North Dundas. And it is gonna be a hooking call. Let's see who's gonna be walking to the box. I believe it is going to be number 81, Todd Marcellus, who will be getting that call. Yeah, as he is skating there, having a chat with the official. Doesn't look like he agrees with it, but he's going to go to the box nonetheless with 11:37 remaining in the first period. Gananoque down by 2, looking to get a goal here and get themselves back on the board, or get themselves on the board and back in this game. Duchesne has that puck at the neutral ice zone, sends it in, stopped up by Jenkins. He's gonna play it out and down the ice, stopped up by Domingo, who sends it over to the far side. Selick will pick that one up on his stick as he sends it back to the D. Duchesne cycles back as they're looking for an outlet pass, sent up the ice, chipped at the blue line, but hits a foot. Then gets carried into the zone by the Rockets. High stick, and that one's gonna be a call going to Gananoque. As Michael Namie wisely brings it back into his own zone to kill as much time on his own penalty. Selick, the only one for Gananoque, pressuring as a collision there, still gets that puck out. And all the way down for icing, as that's gonna kill down the initial penalty to the Rockets to 1:03. Gananoque now will get the high sticking call, But this puck will be in the neutral zone for the icing call. It should be in the neutral zone. We'll see what these refs can figure out here. But Ben Blasco, 2 minutes for ice, sticking with the pressure. As the Rockets are holding it. What do we have here? It looks like they're going to be taking it in the zone. Definitely not the right position, as an icing call on a delayed penalty does come out to the neutral zone. But there is no rule book here in the USHL, so who knows what's going on. 10:41 remaining here as we're on some 4-on-4 action for a minute. As Verbeek backpedals it to the D. Holding it, chips it up to the neutral ice. They're trying to get up. Dame to get neutral ice, but they can't. They get pressured back in the zone. Verbeek got that puck, chopped off his stick. As this 4-on-4 right now seems to be a little bit struggle for the Islanders. We have 30 seconds remaining here before the Rockets go on to a power play. Comes in, shot. Good save made by Hertz. But the rebound had to get collected quick by Duchesne as he had that puck drop right down in front of the net. Now a drive here as Gann's going to try to get out. Final seconds, 13 seconds remaining on the penalty as Brown carries in, takes a bump in the bench, and then taken out by the stanchion was number 44, Adam Beveridge. Here comes Gustafsson in, shot just wide of the net. It's going to come around to the blue line, kept in as they're going to try to send it back, but that's broken up and now is in the neutral zone as Stevens battling for that puck. Onto the stick of McNamee, looking shot, and a glove save made by Hertz. Stops the play at 9:24. 2-0 is the score, and 43 seconds remaining on the penalty to Blasco. These sponsors being announced right now are on the bottom of your screen. Take a look at all the sponsors that are supporting the Gannock Islanders. Harris going to come in across from Gustafsson on this faceoff draw. Gustafsson kicked out of the faceoff, as in will come Fabian Walsh. One by Harris, but grabbed up quickly off that win by the Rockets, as now Gustafsson skating with that puck, looking for someone to get that puck off to. Passes it off to McNamee, chips over this close side here. A little bit of a draw by Krusevic. Back to the point. Jamie shot, hit his stick, goes up over, and a centering opportunity by Gustafsson. Misses everybody and gets cleared out of the zone, but was a great opportunity as Justin Stevens pressuring, trying to get the Rockets through. A missed hit there as Higgs was trying to narrow down in on McNamee, now over into the corner as they're going to battle, trying to get that puck out. A little bit of a hit there. Higgs trying to battle with it in his feet, and it's still stuck in behind there. The net. Now out on to the Rocket stick, turn fired to the center, hit the foot, and then the rebound shot blocked as it comes out of the zone. All the way down into Gannockway's zone, picked up behind the net by Dixon, who's going to carry it up to the circle, carries out of his zone, chips it at the neutral zone all the way down. That's going to be icing, stopping the play at 8:16 in the first period of play. Face-off will be to the left of Hertz. One up by Gannockway is going to drive out of the zone. Here they come with a little bit of speed, trying to chip that puck by. Broken up by the D of North Dundas, and then to the Gannockway line, sent back up. Now another opportunity to drive in. Far side cross, centering another pass, broken up by the leg of Mav Bolger. Bouncing in the slot, shot, hit a leg, goes off to the far side. Now another opportunity as that puck cleared away. Domingo at the blue line stops it from going out, chipped in. Blasco gets onto that puck first with the puck, tries to center it to Domingo. Chopped off his stick as it sits in the slot. And we get picked up by Williams, who takes it behind his net, wraps it on the boards to the point. Here comes Brown. Brown with some speed, backhand towards the net. And that one goes off over to the sideboards and then sent in back in around behind the net. Gannockway looking to move this puck around, keeping a little bit of a scramble here for the Rockets. They have a closed box in, trying to keep anything from the net, and then a chop right in. A little bit of rest stuff. The Gannockway player goes down. as the Rockets aren't letting anybody get near Jenkins. Duchesne taking his time to get up with the Rockets player, but gets up and gets out of that area. He'll go out for a change as that faceoff is going to come to the left of Jenkins as Verbeek comes in for Gianacqua. Verbeek wins that one to the boards. Quick on his re-shot, just wide of the net as they go over to the far side. Wiley gets on it, chips it. Now by the net, centering opportunity, another opportunity. Big save by Jenkins as he robs Verbeek in close. Now here comes the Rockets in. Groats with the puck in the corner, sends it back to the point. Mott has that, but struggling as Palakowski pinches him off on the sideboards here. Trying to drive that puck out of the zone. They can't get it. Puck moving enough for the ref to let it keep going. Gets onto the stick of Rozniak. You guys send it over, but Selick breaks that one up. And then Selick gets another stick on it as it goes over to the corner. And they'll get right in. And then turned out quickly by the Rockets. Rockets trying to gain the zone. Bouncing puck that got chipped. Goes off over the corner. Selick gets that one. Sends it up to the neutral zone. And then it'll get chipped in as they're going to go for some fresh legs as it'll get picked up by Baxter in behind his net as he waits for the team to come in, give some support. They drop back to Baxter and then fire it over the far side as they're going to try to gain out of their zone. Now out of the zone into the neutral zone, trying to dodge some hits as they chip it in deep and will chase it down. Picked up quickly by Dixon behind the net. Drop pass to Latimer, chips it over to Harris. Harris has it on his stick, trying to get it over deep into the corner. He'll be chased down, and a good little bump there leaves that one in. Mercier trying to dig that out. The Islanders still unable to get really much offense going here. And a good shot and a goal. Second of the period. And I don't know if we're going to see a goalie change here at any time soon, but three goals on eight shots for the Rockets, and the Islanders are looking like they're going to be going down 2-0 if they can't figure this out here soon. Right now, the biggest thing they're going to want is to get out of this period without any more going up on the board. Rockets win that one back. And then chip it up to the blue line, driving in. Looking, shot in. And now some shoving. And there you can see the rough stuff starting to come in again. Aqua, as they're not going to like being down by three. You have to think another one that goes in, we may be seeing a goalie change here. I'm not sure if there's an emergency basis, if they're allowed to put in Slack, or if there has to be an injury. Well, we don't know those exact details, but I would expect if he's allowed in, we will probably be seeing him go through. A little bit of a high stick there. Imp on Duchesne, as you can see, he didn't look happy on that one. As that puck comes back to Blasco. Blasco tries to chip it in, can't get it by, as it gets knocked by Harvey, and then sent in the zone over to the far side, as the tracking in is Brown, the tube. Islanders collide in with the Rockets' opportunity. Good stick by Gianacqua to break that one up. Now driving out of the zone, chipped over here, this close side. Brown gets the puck, carrying it into the corner, takes a good bump, leaves the puck, but will come back in support, gives the D a little bit more as they are starting to jam away at that puck, trying to pull it out as it does get out. And the Gianacqua player tripped up there, but no call. Looks like it's coming from the officials, and a great opportunity. And now some shoving on Brown as he crashed in on the net. It looked to me like it was, I think, Higgs who was taking off his feet. Could be wrong, but I do see Higgs on the ice. No call, and then the crash in on the net. This game is going to start to get a little bit physical here, as Gianacqua, not a fan of being down, and tends to go back to their natural ways of their physical game. In comes Verbeek for the faceoff. They're going to kick out McNamee. In will come. I believe that's Gustafsson. Nope, sorry, Walsh went in on that one. As that puck comes out, Salek over there battling on the side boards, but puck gets chipped by, and now here comes a drive by North Dundas coming across, but a good stick by Latimer breaks up, and then the rebound off of the breakup get knocked into the pad of Hertz, who stops it up. 9-3 are the shots in the favor of the Rockets, who were staying with a 1-1 lead at the end of the first game, now staying with a 3-0 lead in this one. Faceoff one by Ian Aukway to the corner. Latimer gets it, but Gustafson jumps in and shoots it quickly. Back to the point, McNamee sends it into the corner, sent to the side of the net, bounced off and right into the slot. But no one there to track that one down as they'll backpedal in their zone, looking for escape as Verbeek got a little bit of energy there, got in, trying to break that play up. They got in on to Hertz, who will stop it up. He doesn't want any action in his zone right now as he's already let three in. And in the finals here, we have to wonder what changes may be made in this first intermission of play in Gan Aukway's dressing room, as I'm sure North Dundas won't have too much other than to say, keep going, what you got going. Faceoff one back to the point, shot coming, save made by Hertz, rebound bouncing, and it looks like it goes off to the side of the net. And covered, as Hertz wasn't going to let that one bounce out again. Has to be playing on his tippy toes right there. All these shots coming through bouncing are causing him quite a lot of distress. Face off one back to the point again. Shot coming in on Hertz, saved up quickly. As there'll be a whistle. 3:57 remaining here in the first period of play. Shots on the scoreboard show 12-4 the Rockets, 4-4 the Islanders. The Islanders have one more shot than the Rockets have goals. Face off in the feet, chipped over to the corner. Onto it is Brown, chips it up to Blasco. Blasco holds it for a second, now turns and fires it to the far side, trying to spring somebody on the far side, but couldn't get it over there to work. It's got chipped quickly, and now onto the stick of the Rockets as they're going to send it to this close side. Chip hit a stick and goes up and out of play. And the faceoff will come just outside the blue line here for Ian Aukway in the neutral zone. Off one to the sideboards, chipped as they try to drive, but it's intercepted by the Rockets and then goes in around the net to Hertz, who will play it to the sideboards, but they're trying to get that one out. Shot in just wide of the net as that's going to come to the blue line, and it's chipped up and out of play, causing a whistle, and that's going to go inside the Ian Aukway zone to the left of Hertz with 3:17 remaining here in this first period of play, which has been all Rockets this game. And the Rockets are looking to push here to get a 2-0 series lead in the best of five. One by Higgs to Brown. Brown backhands it off the boards up to Blasco, who's going to chip it and try to get to Higgs, but doesn't get it by as the Rockets pinch it off on that board. It's close here, trying to get it in deep. They're still gonna drive and they chip it back in their zone, using a little bit of space to their advantage, but again, Aukway doing what they can to pressure. Chip play, grabbed up quickly by the D and then sent in an airmail pass. Here's an opportunity for the Rockets, shot just wide of the net. As Williams trying to get a clear shot to the net. Now again, Aukway coming back the other way into the zone. Higgs drops it back, and a big rocket of a shot by Brown. Blocker saved by Jenkins and set up and out of play, giving a whistle at 2:35 in the first period of play. Not sure why the face-off would be coming over to this close side as they went off the blocker and out of play. Shot from the far side, but the ref decided even though the players and all of us thought it was going to the other side, it would be from this side. Good shot just wide the net. Again, unable to get a good control of that puck after. Pearson sends it to the far side. Stevens didn't have enough to line up the hit, but then they chip it back to Mercier. Mercier coming in, lugging stop, chipping it through, couldn't get it onto the stick of the streaking Islander, and now sent over to the far side as icing. Stop the play. 2:11 remaining here in this second game of the best of five of the 2023-2024 EOSHL Finals. Here the draw. Will Beeman name it into the draw? Will Cam Walsh to face off against Verbeek? 1-2, the corner, good hit there by Salek, taking the Rocket player off his feet, but the Rocket able to get back up quickly, get on that puck, but the Islanders now battling, bouncing that puck through the slot, shot on net, saved by Jenkins, rebound shot, made it by Jenkins, but hit the side of the net, where the netting was, not being able to make it in, and now out of the zone, here comes the Rockets, into the zone, stops up, looking for a centering opportunity, hit a body, and goes in behind the net. Chipped around the sideboards now. Here comes again Aquay out with a drive. Verbeek, whistle coming, and a penalty. So I think this is going to be going to the Rockets for too many men, maybe? I do think this is a bench minor. Yes, so this is a too-many-men call. I believe number 81, Todd Marcellus, is serving the penalty. Again, Aubrey with a minute 39 left here in the first period. We'll get a power play opportunity and try to cut in to the Rockets' lead. Good play there by Duchesne to keep that in. Got down to Domingo. Domingo walks down in behind the net, looking for a far side pass back to the point. Shot by Duchesne. Saved up and kicked off to the corner. Picked up by Gann. Sending it back to Duchesne. Over to the far side. Held. Back to Duchesne. Shot to the side of the net. And that puck broken up before it get out. But a great play by Duchesne. Used a by to block that one in. Now Blasco sends it in deep. Domingo centering. Couldn't get Selleck to get that one on his stick as he swung at that puck coming through. Shot in. They get to go into the intermission with a little bit of light. Face off one by Ken Aquay. Harris sent it back to D. They chip it back to Harris. Harris sends it in the ice as it'll be chased down by Mercer, but Jenkins got to her first. A little bit of a bump by Harris there onto the Rockets player. And that puck is sent in, and that one hit. Hurts looked like he didn't track it well, went off his body, as he has struggled in this game against the Rockets. But Mercer picks that up, chips it up to the ice, goes by everybody. It'll be chased down here by Cowley and chipped over this close side. Now turn back here by Morris, sent in the ice onto Hurts, who grabs out with his glove and will hold it up as he saw that one the whole way. 27.2 seconds remaining in the first period. 13 shots for the Rockets, 9 for Gann Aquay, but the Rockets hold a 3-1 lead here. Gann Aquay needs a win to give themselves a chance to tie this series. This is a short best of five series. 3 wins takes it. Gann Aquay could be coming down to the wire here with only one game left. They're not able to get a win here. So it's all on the line in this home game as well. Chipped all the way down the ice for icing with 12.1 seconds. Gann Aquay just wants this puck away from their net and to go into the intermission with a little bit of momentum. Feeling a little good about themselves by able to get that one goal on the tip from Selleck just recently. Because up to this point, it has been all Rockets this game, especially number 27, Michael Manhamy. He has two goals for the Rockets. Trying to drive that through. Hook there on the feet. I don't see any officials' arms up. So what a first period of play here for the EOSHL Finals here for 2023-2024 between the Gannock Grounders and the North Dundas Rockets. Great game has been. We've seen some hits, some big saves. We've had some pretty good goals coming out of this game. Again, number 27, Michael McNamee, playing amazing. Two goals. He's out there almost, and every time he's on the ice, you're seeing him do something with that puck and making a difference out there. So keeping an eye on him for the rest of this game. Other than that, on Gann's side, good shot from the point, tipped in by Eric Selleck, by Jenkins, who's been staying tall and having an amazing, amazing year in the OSHL. Right now, Gannock quite cheering by two, but that doesn't keep them out. They're going to do what they can to try to get back in. They're in that change room right now discussing what they need to do to get back into this game and what they need to do to stop the attack from the Rockets, because they need to get the goals, but they can't let the Rockets keep pounding them in either. Leif Hertz looking a little shaky back there right now. Hopefully he's able to figure this one out and get it back to where he needs to go. But like I said, right now, he's getting a little shaky. So we'll see what happens. Other than that, they do have Dallas Slack on the bench. Like I said, don't know what's required for him to come in the game. I believe he's emergency part of the team, whether he's an emergency trade or just a lone player. I don't know what the rules is on that, so we'll play it by ear. 3-1's the score, 14 shots to 9. Great game so far. We hope you're enjoying it. We're going to go to the intermission, and I'll be back for the second period of play. gentlemen, welcome back for period two. We got a man up on the board. They're getting ready to go again. North Dundas holding a 3-1 lead. Gianocchi, though, able to get a goal right in the final 2 minutes. It was a minute 30-something in the first period. So they hopefully have some momentum coming out. Let me fire this over here as we're going to get over to the door. As you see, the Rockets are already on the ice. We're just waiting for the Islanders now. This is a loud, energetic, some might say out of control building as we get ready for period number two. The Islanders are making their way to the ice. Lee Vertz is heading his way down to the net in the far zone. He definitely is still up in this game. Like I said, I don't know if they're allowed to throw Dallas Slack in or not. I really don't know all of the ins and outs of what's going on with him on the team. So we'll see what keeps going. Still sunny out. 6:54 here on the clock and the actual time. But if you're watching this, it's going to be much later at night or maybe another day altogether. Again, down one in this series. Looking at potentially going down a second game here and sending themselves to Chesterville to face the Rockets in game three, which would be an elimination game for them. So a win here today would be a big, big change in this series. So you see Higgs comes in against McNamee. Manny wins it back to the D. Little DD pass. As right now, we're on 5-on-5 action. And again, Gianocchi does have a little momentum from just scoring. But the Rockets do have the lead, so that is something that right now is in their favor. A little bit of back and forth here. That puck's going to make it in onto Hertz, who will slip it behind his net and picked up by Brown. Sends it around to the side boards as they're going to battle. Picked up quickly by Higgs. Higgs chips it out. Now a drive sent over up to Deshane, who chips it in. And we'll chase that one down as it goes up in behind the net. Looking for that one, bounced off the glass, stays in the zone. Higgs chips it back in deep. Glasgow tries to get it to Domingo, goes in behind the net. Domingo's down there. They're battling, try to pull that puck out from in behind the net. Comes out on the Gant stick, but goes off into the corners. Glasgow puts it back to Higgs. Higgs wraps it right back around as it's going to come over to Domingo, who will stop it up. Has D support, but sends it right back in as they'll get chipped in at the side. Domingo holding it, sends it towards the net, couldn't get it, picks it back up aside the net, holding it, shot towards the net, and a good leg save by Jenkins, and he was able to kick Deshane off his feet after the save and then keep it. That shot, I think, went off the side of the net. Opportunity here for the Rockets, gloved up by Hertz, but we've had a pretty great start to this second period. Minute 24, and the Rockets fans here, we'll give you a little view of the fans in the stands who are cheering their team on as they're ready for a third consecutive championship. And they know this is part of the process, and they're going to be here with their team chanting and cheering them on the whole way. Reeves trying to get a piece, now back into the corner. Salek has it, chips it in behind the net, gets over to Wiley's stick. Wiley chips up to the blue line, they get it out of the zone. Couldn't get any more advancement though as it gets onto the stick of Reese. He gets ridden out into the boards, stays on his feet though. Chip play, hit, a body goes off over into the corner. They're going to battle for that one. Salek grabs that one up in the air, gets it off, and then chipped out. Now here comes a drive for Verbeek. Comes in, sends it back pass to Balakowski's shot. Rebound as they're trying to scramble to get that one off. Can't get a shot off as it comes back to the point onto Wiley's stick. Wiley sends it right back down into the corner to Salek. Salek with it, trying to get a shot in on that. Gets it on, saved up by Jenkins, and that one cleared up and out of play, but hit the glass first, so it won't be a call. Will be in the zone though.
Sponsored by our friends, Take Lead Realtors, DGN Middleware.
shows as you hear or these sponsors on the screen below. Check them all out as they're supporting the Gannock Rounders. Now a shot from the point. Bouncing bucket. We have a goal. I'm not sure if that one got tipped or just made it straight in off of the stick of Chris Latimer. It looks like he's being led by Brock Higgs. So Higgs got a piece of Latimer's shot. Unable to get it by, making it 3-2 here in the second. And now Gannock definitely has momentum as they've scored the last two goals here in this game, giving them only a one-goal deficit and a chance to tie up game two. Face off one by North Dundas. Back, DD, shipped on the far boards. Gets in, drive for it, onto it quick. Will be Higgs, and he got, sorry, Tanner Williams got in on that one, got that one broken up first. Battle for the puck, hitting some bodies. Centering opportunity, bouncing all over the place as Gann's trying to get it. Goes off over into the corner. As the D's gonna use their body to block it up. In comes support as Harris sends it back. Dixon gonna chase it down. Can't get to it, but he had his D partner supporting. Comes up, now chipped out of the play. Gann gets it to the line, or center ice. Now he'll get through. Here comes Latimer, whoop, with a shot. Can't get, Stevens couldn't get that pass as they tried to get it through to him. Now the point, Mercier has it, leaves it for Bouchard. Now over side side, hard shot coming, but Brown got that bouncing puck and couldn't get enough of it as it got out of the zone. Mercier sends it back to Brown. Brown with the puck in mind, that stops up, avoiding the hit. Now holding it, sends it up ice. Stopped up in the neutral zone, turned back the other way. Now Gustin coming in on it, has Coda tracking. Can't get it. Brown gives him the business into the boards. Puck stays in on the line. McNamee backhand. That one close to the far side now. Shot from the point. Good save by Hertz. Rebound bad away. Right back to the point. Another shot on to Hertz. Sitting right in the feet of the D. Picked up by Bouchard. Sent up to the blue line. Hit the legs of the official. Offside is the call as they have to wait for the tag up. He just gets chipped in on the net. Dropped at the side by Duchesne. Duchesne up to Coda. Coda bats out the boards out to the neutral zone. Picked up by McNamee and then he sends it all the way in. Right in onto Hertz, who's going to hold it up. Taking the whistle. 15-32 in the second period of play. We have 11 shots scanned, 17 for the Rockets. Faceoff to the left of Hertz. In will come Razdrak against Verbeek. Verbeek wins it back to Wiley. Wiley gets that puck up, turns, tries to backhand it up out of the zone, gets it to the blue line, does make it out, but it's turned over to the Rockets, who bounce it right back in behind the net, stopped up by Hertz. Had a little bit of a problem there with his D, getting that one to settle down, and now a scramble in the corner as Selleck driving for that puck, but it gets chipped back the other way, over to Wiley. Wiley pinched off in the corner as he's going to try to get out, gets up to Selleck. Selleck sends it across ice. Now a drive for Palakowski, stops at the blue, sends it in. Can't get that one to Verbeek cleanly as Verbeek was tied up with the D. Drive there at the blue line. Selleck uses his body to get onto that puck. It's in the feet. He uses the body to chimp. Sends it back to Wiley. Wiley in the high slot. Shot in, and it's saved up by Jenkins. Quick in is Selleck, and now some shoving. Selleck takes a shot up high by Beveridge. He hasn't hit, swung back at him, but you know that's going to be a target now as Selleck, oh, does a little pump fake and then rubs the face of this player here for the Rockets. He's getting under their skin. The penalty did end up coming to the Rockets' way. Mott is going to get a penalty for 2 minutes. I believe that's Mott up there. Hard to see. There's a little bit of a metal structural bar in front of the cage blocking the number for him, but I do believe that's seven. Yes, it is number seven. So slashing is the call to him. Gannock right now. I'm not dreaming, but now shorthanded. An opportunity offside as Gustafson was just a step over the line. Getting a whistle. Faceoff will be just outside the Gannock zone. as Blasco comes in across from McNamee for the drop of the puck here. One back by Gianacque into Duchesne, who's going to take it up into the side of his net. Gianacque on the power play needs to get this down in the zone. Here comes Blasco with some speed, drops that puck off to Higgs, centering across. And now another opportunity, setting a dive across with a big save. I didn't catch the number on that player, but the Rockets player came across, stopping that potential scoring opportunity. Now Gianacque, though, breaking it back into the zone. Here comes Higgs, centering across. Chip play by Domingo, and we have a goal as Gianacque ties it up in the second period of play. And now, what a turn of events from 3-1 in the first period to 3-3, and we still have 14:06 remaining in this second period of play. He says Dominic, I say Domingo. I don't know what his name is, to be honest with you. Harris gets the puck, gets it, starts driving in as Stevens with him, cuts over the blue line, goes into the ice slot, sends it across, bouncing in the legs, gets grabbed up by Jenkins. You can see Dixon giving it to the officials. Takes up now. Takes. Comes in. Takes off. Was stopped on the advancement of the Rockets player. Now Higgs has that puck. Backhand passes it over to Blasco. Trying to center it, but couldn't get it. Now come over to this corner. Blasco gets it back to the point. Shot just wide as Duchesne couldn't track that one down and on the net. Comes in behind Domingo. Backhand passes it on to Higgs. Higgs back to Domingo. Domingo holding it behind the net. Looking, centering opportunity. And we have a goal as Gianacque takes the lead. 4-3 here with 13:20 remaining in the second period of play. Gianacque now on the right side of this scoreboard. And looking like they're going to try to take a series tying game here. Some conversation going on with the official at center ice. Gianacque ties it up. Or sorry, takes the lead. My apologies. That was Ben Blasco that gets that one in. Dominique with the assist. And then Higgs. Salek chips that puck up the sideboards, gets it up to Duchesne. Duchesne chips it, takes the body, and it goes in behind the net. Palakowski tries to get there and flip it right in front of the net. Couldn't get it. Chip back to the point, kept in the zone. Bouncing puck gets by, comes over to the corner. Quick onto it is the Rockets, who send it up to the neutral ice. Bouncing puck gets over the line, and 71. Doug Harvey just goes in over the line. And now you can see some shoving going on. And now Salek's in there as well. Salek will drop the mitts with anybody. We'll see if anyone's willing to go with him. Doug Harvey has his helmet off. Salek right there. Doesn't look like Harvey wants to initiate with him. He wants Duchesne. So I'm not sure exactly what's taking place here. So that's what's going on. Baxter's going for cross-checking, even though 71 is going into the box. They did say 77. I'm not sure if that was 71's up on the board, so I think that was just an announcement error. As you hear there, they let you know. 4-3, Gianacque now with the lead, has a power play. off of a little bit of an undisciplined play by number 71, Doug Harvey. We'll see if this ends up costing the Rockets here. As Gann trying to utilize momentum they've gained here in this second period to their favor. Gann Akwai holding the puck in the zone. Back to Duchesne. Duchesne down and low. Back up to Duchesne. Shot bounces just wide of the net as Gann Akwai has it on the stick. Back to Higgs. Higgs holding onto it. Back over to Duchesne. Duchesne backhand pass to Demi. Over to the net. Tip by Selick. Just goes wide. Back over to Higgs' stick. Higgs sends over to the far side. Ming has it, sends it in towards the slot. Puck misses, grabbed up by 77 Baxter, sent out. Here's an opportunity as Gustafson will get to that puck first. Duchesne will give him the business. Dominique comes in as well, gets the puck. And we have a penalty for Gann Akwai for holding. And that's going to negate the last minute 20. See Duchesne giving it to the official as he has to be careful. He's taking too long to get to the bench. He could look getting a misconduct here, but now the referees are conversing over here at the boards. Maybe there will be a reversal here. Wild night here in your evening in Gann Akwai. Like, I think they're going to be giving a penalty here to the Rockets. I'm not sure if it's going to be one aside. But we'll leave it here right on the scoreboard. Oh, and you can see Gustafson giving it now to the officials. He's going into the box. So they're going to give Duchesne and Gustafson a holding the stick call. I do believe I saw a misconduct call there as well. So we'll wait for a minute for that. But I think that might have went to Gustafson. If that does, that puts him out for the remainder of this period, which would be devastating to the Rockets as he's one of their top players. But it looks like the Islanders were able to put a case forward and the officials agreed. Pulling a double holding. Puck goes up and out of play, dodging. Boucher, he's got it in the glove to give it to the official though. Still some conversation with the official and Gustafson at the box. If he did get a 10-2, he keeps going, he could get himself ejected. Puck into the far side, McNamee centers it, shot by Walsh, just wide, gets onto it quick as Moores. And he turns it in, back in behind the net, they step out, shot! Good shoulder save there made by Hertz. As that puck get up and now out will come Blasco, backhands it. Got broken up, now Selick has it, as he's gonna try to drive in the zone. Puck picked up by the D, sent to the far side. As he'll try to get up to center ice here. Walsh has it, turns it. Gann Akwai intercepts. Puck now onto the stick. Of Blasco chipped in to Verbeek, who came on the ice for Selick. As he'll send it back over to Blasco, back down and low, shot! And that one off the backboards, bounces out, chipped to the sideboards, as they're gonna stick with it. Gann Akwai under it, sends it back. Bouncing puck gets by, now a foot race for the puck. Out comes Hertz to play it. And he's able to get that puck up to the neutralized zone. Stopped up by Domingo at the blue line, sends over far side, shot, big save made by Jenkins. Gann Akwai holding it, sending it in down low, back out here, Domingo looking for a shot. And a good deflection sends that one up and out of play for a whistle. 10:40. Sponsors, Team Best Confectionery, Skilders Glen Golf Course, face off into the boards. Dixon gets to it, chips it around, comes back. Verbeek with the puck behind the net, kicks it to his stick, trying to do a drive. Back to the point to Dixon. Oh, but Dixon's skate goes all the way down. Now a rush for it. Here comes the Rocket shot, and a big save made by Hertz. As the Rockets send it back to the blue line, goes by everybody and down onto the stick of Jenkins, who will leave it behind his net. Rockets stop back up looking, send up the far side boards to neutral ice, chips it down in. Not enough for icing as he'll get picked up by Latimer. Sends it up the ice, bouncing off the glass to Palakowski, who chips it to the blue line, but able to be turned back by Froats as Dixon now gets it in the zone deep, sends it up. Now here comes Verbeek, sends it up far side, driving in, stops up. They send it over to this far side. Now to Verbeek, shot, good save made by Jenkins with the leg, even the rebound coverage as well, as that puck came behind the net. Moving around, centering over to this far side. Here comes a shot from Brown, off the post, and comes back to the blue line, kept in by Latimer. Sent in, tip, just goes off over to the corner. Brown chips it in behind. Verbeek has it, again, moving the puck well to the point. Chips it in as it's bouncing. It'll get grabbed up by Mercier in behind the net. Now back to the blue line. Send back in to Palakowski's stick as he's going to drive over to the sideboard. Spins it back. Verbeek gets it, centers it. Mercier couldn't get a stick on it as it goes over to the corner. Being pressured, taking off his feet. Kurzweil, they center it. Couldn't get that one settled down either. And now here comes the Rockets with the puck as they send it to the blue line. Couldn't get it in deep, but now some good coverage keeps on that puck. Here's an opportunity. Rockets opportunity. Couldn't get that one to settle down as it was going in front of the net. Hertz was sprawling side to side. Now here comes Brown, drops it to Stevens. In comes Kota. Kota drive, centering opportunity. Harris couldn't get that one to settle down as it was bobbling. Now back to Harris. Harris holding the puck, centers it towards the net, but hits the leg and gets covered up. But a good play there by Stevens with the puck. Says it. Shot, rebound. Bouncing puck. Couldn't get that one to track down as Gann chases it off to the corner. Hog tied was Brown. He does some chumming and then a big hit by Kota as they're firing it up. Shot just wide of the net. He gets tripped up. Still no calls. The refs are letting this go. This keeps up. You're going to see some wild action here in this game. Harris sends it in. Stopped up by Jenkins behind the net. Wraps it around the boards. Back to where the players are coming off the bench. Blasco battling for it. Gets it on his stick. Centering it. Hit a leg as it comes off to that sideboards. Again, Ockley trying to get possession, trying to break it up, couldn't get it broken up, gets kicked in the zone. Quick onto it will be the Rockets. Again, pinches them off on the sideboards. Good battle in there, trying to pull that puck out. Latimer now in deep, chipping at it, goes in behind the net. Puck chipped by Higgs, as he's gonna drive up this sideboards here, up to the neutral zone, being harassed, gets it chipped in the zone, but it'll get grabbed up quickly by the D of the Rockets as they send it up the ice, trying to spring. That one, I believe, is gonna be an icing call with 7:15 remaining here in the second period of play. 3-1 was the score at the end of the first, 4-3. Right now, the score in the second is Gann Aquay's cranked up the offense as they are in a hard game, as if the Rockets right now hold a one game series lead in the best of five. Takes three to win. Gann Aquay wants to tie this up at one. Duchesne stops at the blue line, sends it right back in. In onto the stick of Verbeek. Backhand passes it in to the corner. A little bit of a drive there as they try to get that one out. Selleck has it behind the net, centering to Duchesne, shot. Rebound, picked right back up by Duchesne as he's pinched off down and deep. Verbeek got taken off his feet there, no call. As you can see, digging also took off Duchesne off his feet as this puck being held along the sideboards. Selleck keeping on puck, trying to chip it down deep. Chipped at the blue, capped by Duchesne. As they're gonna bow for that puck. Down low, comes out. Cali sends it all the way down. And that one, I believe, might have went up and out of play. So it's gonna come out with 6:21 remaining here in the second period. 19 shots for Gann, 18 or North Dundas. How'd you pick? Coming in against Higgs. In the feet. One, back, two. The rock is D. As Baxter sends it in, he'll go out to the corner. Little bump there by Gustafson. As the Rockets hold possession in the zone over to the far side. Brown tried to get there, but the shot made onto the net first. Now chipped out. Here comes Blasco. Chips it by the D. Tries to get by. He's going to have to chase that puck down in. Gives a hit to Baxter. Trying to get on that puck, causing some havoc. Sent all the way over the ice. Down for icing.
Don't forget to purchase your 50-50 ticket if you haven't already.
A little coaching there coming from Gian Acque. That's going to set up to the right of Jenkins. In will come Higgs to the faceoff. Scramble draw. One back by Rajnak. Rajnovic. Sorry about that. And kept in at the line there by Higgs. Now driving out. Chipped up to Kushner. Turn fired in deep. Grabbed up behind the net. Looking back out front to the side. Looking shot through the leg. Save made by Hertz. Rebound grabbed up by Ginn. Now here comes the opportunity as Blasco taking that puck in over the blue line. Looking, sends it towards the net, and a drive through. Chipped by Domingo. That was a dangerous opportunity here. But it goes up and out of play. Again, Ogway putting on a lot of good pressure here. Don't know what exactly took place in the intermission, but whatever it was, sparked life in Gian Acque. One back. I think that was by Walsh. That puck at the blue line battle. Coda broke it up. They're going to try to get it out, but got back up by the Rockets. Sent in deep behind the net. They're trying to center it. Gann's able to get there quickly as Dixon drives it up the line. Takes a bump. Still sticks with it. Sorry, that was Reese. Not Dixon that got that one. Drives in, gets up to Smith. Smith's shot. Just wide of the net. Goes over to the far side to be tracked down. And that gets onto the stick of Harvey. Sent up now. Here comes opportunity for Williams. Williams' shot. Bounce that puck. Bobbling in. Dealt with. And then a little bit of a collision going into the net. It looks like both players no worse for wear, as that was Reese and Mott. A little 7-on-7 violence into the net. Both come away no worse for wear. So the faceoff will be outside the zone, as a team, the Rockets player, was the one to drive it off the net. Harris will come in against McNamee. Face off won by the Rockets. Wrapped in around the boards. Couldn't get a stop on it. Was Hertz. He almost lost his stick, but it did get to the blue line. And then got unable to be cleared, actually. Looked like it was cleared, but it was not. Now an opportunity. Shot coming. McNamee, good save with the shoulder. And then Hertz dives in on it. Stopping the play at 4:15. 19 shots for Gann, 20 for the Rockets, 4-3 for Gian Acque. Right now, Hertz is going to give himself a little bit of equipment adjustment, make sure he's all good for this faceoff. As Harris will send it across from McNamee. One over the side boards, grabbed up by Gann, wrapped to the blue line, kept in, good battle in low. Players go down, no penalty call coming. As the Rockets fans and bench wanted one. Picked up here in the blue line, driven into the zone. Coming in, short side boards, sent in net. Good move made there by Hertz to deflect that away. And then a hit behind the net, which sets up the crowd. And we're going to have a call. And there's going to be an injury on the play. And this might be a serious call coming. He definitely went down for a hip check. Wedthrow, oh, he's kicked. He is gone from the game. 66. Brett Gustafson gone. Duchesne wants a piece. So. And it finally erupts here, as you can see. Gustafson on his way off. He was already kicked out. Charges at the player. I don't know if that will extend his suspension, but he's gone. And now tempers are flaring. Celek engaged up with Harvey, as he's already had twice with Harvey. Callie hooked up with Higgs, and this game looks like it's going to be getting out of control here. I believe they're kicking out Duchesne from the game as he was getting into it with Jenkins on the way off the ice. This has turned into quite a show here between these two teams, as we have been waiting for it to explode here in this playoffs for Gann. As you can hear Gustafson down there. This has become a common occurrence here in Gananoque, where fans and the players of the away team get into altercations. I've said it before, the players need to get right off of the ice. Otherwise, the league needs to start implementing bigger suspensions, as there should be no player interacting with a fan, as you can see here again. Gustafson out of the room, not going in, which is going to have to be looked at by the league, because this is becoming an issue, as we've already had altercations with what some would say would be fights in the stands during the game, between altercations that took place between players and fans. Hopefully somebody from the Rockets will get Gustafson in the change room, as he should not be in the center causing issues right now. But like we said, this game has gotten right up and going here. Doesn't like my commentating, but I don't really care. Well, at least he's finally going to the room now, so hopefully that will calm that down. He got 5 minutes on the board for that. We'll see what Duchesne gets for his, but right now, again, getting a little bit out of control here at the USHL Finals. It's game two. It's 4-3. Still, lots of discussion by the officials. But again, Gananoque has nobody in the penalty box, and North Dundas has nobody in the penalty box. So I'm not sure what's going to be the final calls here. I know Duchesne was taken off the ice, and Gustafson was taken off the ice. Whether they're going to be allowed, they're coming back, I believe Gustafson was tossed from the game, so chances are if he was, so was Duchesne. But they could be removed just for the remainder of the period, which is a possibility. We'll see what happens here. But we will wait as the referees sort it all out. Still yet to hear any call here for what Gustafson has. He does have 5 minutes on the board, but to the misconducts or whether anything else is coming to that, we'll hear momentarily. Dixon is having a conversation with the official right now. we'll see what comes of this. All this erupted from a hit behind the net as the player was being escorted to the box. He was tossed from the game as he made his way to the dressing room door, got into an altercation with the players, charged at the players, started a little bit of a melee, got taken off the ice. And since we have had just a lot of standing around while stuff gets figured out. 2 minutes on the board too. Number 22, Wyatt Cota. I believe that is to Deshane being served by Wyatt Cota. And then number 66, Brett Gustafson, 5 minutes. So Gananoque will have a little 4-on-4 for 2 minutes and then a 3-minute power play that won't be ended by any goals. Face off won by Higgs, back to Deshane. Deshane battling, trying to get that puck out. The puck does get out by by the Rockets and sent down the ice onto Hertz. Grabbed up by Latimer, sent up to the neutral zone, driving in comes Blasco. Blasco in, stops up, looking for someone to feed the puck to, sends over to the far side, grabbed up by Dixon and sent in behind the net. Higgs wraps it around. Can't get it. Back to the point. But kept in at the blue line as they keep battling. The Rockets trying to drive here. Comes in over center ice. In. McNamee stops up. Looking. Sends it towards the net but hits the body. Comes down as Walsh grabs up that stick. Or puck on his stick. Back to the point. Krzyzewski over to the far side. Looking for a shot. Shot in on Hertz. Saved and puts off to the corner as they'll get chipped up. Picked up at the side of the net and now sent out, but broken up right at the blue line. Latimer had to do a good job, get in, took a little bit of a bump, but gets over to Blasco. Blasco coming in, centers it to Verbeek. Verbeek chips, gets grabbed up by Marcellus, and then on to the net of Jenkins. He'll hold it. Gang of whistle with 2:34 remaining here in the second period of play. Verbeek to set up here at this faceoff draw to the right of Jenkins. One back towards the Gananoque D, but intercepted quickly by Mott. Mott coming in, goes off to the corner with the battle, trying to battle, poked out in front of the net, picked up by Gananoque, and they're going to skate that one out. Here they come, up over the line comes Palakowski, looking shot, hit a leg of Radjvanak, and goes up and out of play. So the faceoff will be staying in the Rocket zone. It looks like it's going to be to the right, of Jenkins. Verbeek will be coming in to set up here off of this draw. 31 seconds remaining on the penalty to Gananoque. Deshane served by Cota. And a shot. That one goes up and out over to the blue line, kept in. As time's ticking down on the penalty, Gananoque getting ready for their power play. But here comes the Rockets out the other way, looking, utilizes 4-on-4, drop back. Here's another drop pass shot, hit the leg of Verbeek and goes off to the side boards. Now chip back to Verbeek. Verbeek has it, has to cut back at the front of the net as he was going to take a bump. Got that puck off first. Now switched over here to Marcellus. Comes out, sent down the ice. Penalty over to Gananoque. They're on the power play for 3 minutes. That's a major, so they won't get knocked down if there's a goal. Back pass towards the D. Grabbed up now. Here is Verbeek. Sends it across the ice and is going to get that in. Now drives in on Dominique's stick. Guts in. Has a little bit of a battle and gets out onto the Rockets, who send it down the ice. He'll get stopped up by Hertz and left for Brown, who will grab that one up and use his net as low protection. Comes through as we cut down to a minute 20 here in the second period of play. Chipped in as he'll get stopped up by Jenkins. Has Blasco coming in, so he sends over the far side and gets intercepted by Selleck. Selleck with that puck stops up, looking for someone to pass to. Puts it back to the point. Now over to this far side here where Brown is. Brown shot just wide of the net as Higgs trying to get a piece of it. Now onto the stick of Selk, back over to the far point. Now back, Selk set up in front of the net. Brown shot, hit a leg, onto Higgs' stick, sent to the front of the net. They couldn't track that one down. Now from the point, sent in, rebound kicked out to the slot. And now here comes the Rockets in on a break. Save made by Hertz, and a second save made by Hertz. As we have 37 seconds remaining here in the second period, Hertz standing tall. had this 4-3 lead. In comes Brown. Stops up. Sends it out of the zone all the way down. And that will get stopped by Hertz. And we have a whistle. As it looks like there's a penalty call coming potentially. Or no, maybe it was touched with a high stick. Faceoff will be to the left of Hertz here in the Ganakwe zone with 23.2 seconds. McNamee's going to come into the faceoff dot, setting up, and he will go up against Brock Higgs here. Ganakwe has a minute 36 remaining on the 5-minute major. Verbeek jumped there, so Higgs gets tossed out. Verbeek will come into the faceoff dot, looking to get the win here against McNamee. Faceoff one back to the D, chipped in around behind the net, grabbed up by Latimer and sent down the ice, chipped out, Verbeek's stick explodes as he was going to try to drive into the zone. Higgs gets that one, sends it over, shot coming, just misses the net off of the stick of Palakowski. Verbeek has a new stick, and in their battling, player gets tripped up. They try to center, grabbed up by the Rockets, and then a little bit of a bump at the end, and that's going to start up here. But it looks like, yes, cooler heads will prevail, and they'll walk away. A little bit of arguing in this against each other, but that's all that's going to happen right now. So we're going to end up here this second period. What do we talk about here? What a period of play. We had Ganakwe put three up on the board, none up on the board for the Rockets in that period. So Ganakwe holding a 4-3 lead. There's a big hit behind the net. Ganakwe in the Ganakwe zone, which was down on the far side for North Dundas, in behind the net by Gustafson. As he was skating off the ice, it was indicated he's out. As he was skating from the bench towards the dressing room, got into an argument with, I believe it was Brock Higgs, lunged at Brock Higgs to start initiating a little bit of a tussle. And then what happened was the referee took him and pulled him off the ice. Things kind of settled down. Duchesne was taken off the ice as well. Gustafson stayed down in between the bench. Arguing, yelling off, causing a little bit of a disturbance. This has happened here in Gann a couple times. You know, it's best that the player just walks off the ice, goes to the change room. No need to be interacting with that. You've been taken out of the game. But it did happen, as you heard. Didn't like what I was commenting, but I don't care because I'm not here for Brett Gustafson. I'm here to bring you guys the game. So that's where we sit here. Third period coming. We have a 4-3 game. Ganakwe needs to win this one because they right now they're down 1-0 in the series, and they want to tie this up, take it in to Dundas, win it, and come back here and have a 2-1 lead coming into the game here. So we'll see what happens. But I'm going to kick you the intermission, and then we'll be back for the third period of play. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. I'm just getting my camera set up. What a second period play that was. Three goals scored in total, all from Dan Aykroyd, giving them the 4-3 lead into this third period of play. Had some issues there in the second with Brett Gustafson getting into it with the players coming off the ice after he was, I believe, ejected. We didn't actually get a full call on that, so whether he was ejected or he was just taken out of that period, we'll find out here in the third. But right now, we're going to be going back into the second period of play, or third period of play, 4-3, again, ugly leading. Down, though, by one goal in the series. Rockets lead the series, so we'll see what happens here. As right now, the Rockets are coming onto the ice. It looks like no 71 on the ice. No 66. So Doug Harvey and Brett Gustafson are out of the game. Chad Duchesne was also ejected in this game. So we'll see what happens. If he's back, I don't believe he will be. I think he was ejected for the game, not a 10-minute, but Saturday afternoon at 3:30 will be the next home game for Balderson's Hockey Nation. If the series goes that far, now Dan Aykroyd winning tonight would assure that game to happen. So we will start it up here. Hey, Grant Amy for the faceoff, won by Higgs back to the D. That was Domingo playing D back there at that point. And he just gets it back to the other D partner as they get set right back up here. As usually on this setup, again, Aykroyd would have Duchesne there, but out of the game. We have different setup going right now. Rockets turn and fire out of the zone as they're killing down the remaining 45 seconds on the 5-minute major to Gustafson. And they'll get onto the stick of Eric Selick. Comes on in the zone, drives into the corner, takes a little bit of a bump, trying to stick with the puck though, as it comes back to the point. Now on to Brown's stick, Brown into the corner. Sitting back, Glasgow gets it down to the front of Selick, and we have a goal as they feed Selick all alone in front of the net. And he puts it by, making it 5-3, and there's still 21 seconds remaining. A second goal this game. Coming up big in this playoff game. Yeah! Fans are excited as the Islanders now have the insurance marker. It's onto that puck, got it quick, and as you can see there, Mott went for a ride after that. Again, Aykroyd trying to keep that puck in. Held at line by Latimer. Sent over to the far side. Shot coming, and that hit a body right back to D. Then they sent it in. Couldn't get that one to center in front of the net. Verbeek sends it back to the D, but they had vacated the line. And now here comes an opportunity for the Rockets. Backhand shot towards the net. Just pushed off to the side by Hertz, and then gets driven down the sideboards, back in now behind the net, looking to get that out front. They center it, and a big save made by Hertz to keep that one out. Now a drive in, shot towards the net, saved up by Hertz, rebound, chipped by Dixon's stick, up and out of play. What a save that was by Hertz. 18-14 remaining here on the clock. 22 shots for Dan Aykroyd, 25 shots for North Dundas. Dan Aykroyd holding a 5-3 lead, trying to tie this series up here on a Sunday evening. Shot coming, good save made there by Jenkins. Now over into the corner, stopped up as they're going to drive it out of the zone. Cutting across center. As he picks back up the puck and sends it in. He'll go in behind the net, picked up there by Brown. Takes a little bit of a bump. And that puck goes into the feet, grabbed up, and now a hit by Reese. Takes the Rockets player off their feet. Shot into some bodies, picked up by Higgs. Coming in, stopped up as Blasco sends it across. Couldn't connect with that pass, it got broken up. But Higgs was down there in the corner. Able to stop that one up enough for Blasco to come and get it. He sends it over to the far side, they shoot on the net. And it's quickly grabbed up by the glove of Jenkins, stopping the play. Dan Ockway holding a two-goal lead and only 17-26 away from tying the series, forcing a game four and giving them a chance as they're looking to get their first USHL championship as they're playing for their third year in a row. The North Dundas Rockets. The Rockets are two-time champions in the last two seasons. They're looking to be a three-peat. Again, Ockway trying to see what they can do to stop it. Good shot in, tipped just wide. Chap towards the net, hit Salek's stick, and then Verbeek shot on it. Couldn't get that one to settle in. So it comes over to the blue line, stopped up by Salek. Backhand towards the net, tipped by the D. Almost threw off Jenkins, but then got turned off to the corner. Chip by Salek now. Out of the zone comes North Dundas over to the far side. Stopped up, taking a little bit of bump by Murray. Sends in behind the net. Sorry about that. Comes back to the point. Shot coming. Wide of the net. Goes over to the far side. Salek trying to get reach on that one. Couldn't. McNamee chips it back over into the corner. Stevens trying to push off. The Rockets player has support from Murray as they all battle in deep. Bounced it off to the sideboard. Suverbeek, who sent back to the point, but now a shot coming. And that one hit Stevens. That one hit him hard as he's going to vacate his way to the Islanders bench. That stung him hard. Coming in, Gann gets that one with some speed. Has to dance the line, was Brown. But went in offside, stopping the play. 16-20 remaining in the third period of play. Shard for Gann Ockway on this faceoff. Wins it back to the D, chips it on the boards. Gets it to the blue line, but then turned right back. Has a good battle there with Throats, trying to get that one. Now turned and chipped in to the zone. North Dundas gets a piece of it. Now they chip it into Gann's zone as they'll go in down behind the net. Quick onto it is Williams. He gets pinched off by Bouchard in behind the net, trying to get that puck out. A good battle there as Dixon comes in as well, trying to pull that one out. Comes out onto the stick of the Rockets. They try to center it, but Bouchard got a stick in there. Turn back to Froetz. Now Brown trying to get on that. Takes a bump. Gets that puck up to Kota, but got chipped before it gets to him and gets out of the zone into the neutral ice. Picked up by the Rockets. Mott sends it in. He's going to flutter off the sideboards. Grabbed up by Smith. Sent over to the far side as Brown chases that one down. Flicks it out to the neutral zone all the way down into North Dundas territory. They go a little D to D as they look for some support to send it out, but broken up by Verbeek coming in, looking shot. And that one might have caught the glove of Jenkins. Goes off, though, to the far boards and all the way out into Gann Ockway zone. In behind the net was Latimer, chipped it up to the blue line and it got out to the neutral zone, but lost control. Let's see here. We're going to have a penalty.
Bad call.
So it looks to me like offsetting calls coming here. One to Kota, one to Bradley Stitt, number 31, 2 minutes on the board. Kota, not sure why Kota's in the box. He does not have a penalty up on the board. That puck sent out of the zone, so Kota may, not sure if he has a misconduct or what's going on there, but he is in the box, nothing up on the board. Puck now cleared up to the neutral zone. In comes Gananoque. Ziggs chips it on, trying to beat by Beveridge. And a bump here, and we have a call. Interference as the official makes the call, and you can hear not happy are the fans. As Adam Beveridge makes his way to the box, and again Aquay to a 5-on-3 for a minute 24. Glasgow is going to set in against from Walsh. Face off one back to the point. Over now to Domingo. Domingo back up to Brown. Over to Domingo. In deep. Centering opportunity. Couldn't sell that one. Losing a footing was Blasco. Back on his knees. Gets the puck. Another game possession again. Moving around this active triangle. Shot. And a goal! As Brown puts it in. Second penalty to Adam Beveridge, and that now gives Gananoque three-goal lead with 14:05 remaining here in this third period of game two. Glasgow's going to set up here in the draw against Froats. Run it back to the point. Brown will circle back. Cut around. Puck gets up. Here's Selk. Selk shot. Rebound. Save made as Froats gets on that. And we'll send it down the ice. Puck now in Gananoque zone, picked up by Domingo, comes through the blue line, up through center ice, driving in, gets it in to the zone, sent over to Selick. Selick stops up, looking for a pass, sends it across to the blue line, back to Brown with a hard shot just wide of the net, grabbed up by Higgs, back over to the point, back up to Brown, over here to Domingo, looking as Selick low, he's going to start to drive, sends it towards the point, but it missed everybody. Come out, a good hard race for the puck. Strohs goes to get there, but in first is Brown, ripped up. And it looked like Strohs took a slap shot, and I'm not sure. I think that was in the direction of the ref, and I think he's going to get a misconduct for that one. I don't think he intentionally shot it at the referee, but it did go down the ice in that direction, and that's going to send him to the penalty box. 4 minutes on the board. Probably. And they're going to kick him.
That's discipline.
Third player for the Rockets in this game. This game full of shenanigans and excitement. Hey! Sorry about that. I had to get the person away from the camera. They're looking to move that puck around. Shot, rebound, save, and that one almost trickled through. We do apologize. There's a lot of excitement going down in between these two benches. One of the reasons that we have, sorry about that, all this excitement going on where I have to direct some people away from my cameras. I do apologize. Just excitement here, ladies and gentlemen, in a packed house. So 12:48 remaining, 18 seconds on the first penalty, 3:44 on the second. As Gananoque has been enjoying an extended 5-on-3 here, as it looks like North Dundas is coming unraveled here in this game. And this is what Gananoque needs to put some doubt in the Rockets' mind as they want to try to get this championship for the first time in their third attempt against the Rockets. Puck moving around. Hits coming harder now from the Rockets. They're trying to take a pound of flesh from these Islanders here in this game. Shot in, trickling puck, and now, as you can see here, lots of shoving coming in front of the net. The referees will want to make sure they keep an eye on this, because these will be the kind of things that will set in fists flying on both sides.
Put the local grocer on the ice.
The referee giving the call there to the keeper. As you can see, this game just what we expect out of these two strong, hard teams against each other. They don't leave anything out on the ice. They go for it full speed. And we do have an issue here, if I show you here, on the score clock. As they're popping up the penalties, they have a 0 second penalty up there. I think they're just trying to get that one taken off. And everything's set up here, not exactly sure. It should roll off the second they start the clock, but there might be something else they want up on there, so we'll see. But right now, that seems to be the issue, is getting this clock figured out here. 29 shots to 26 in favor of Gananoque, leading 3 by 3 goals, 6-3 is the score. But the Rockets do lead the series by one, so they have a little bit of space, as you can see here. An absolute packed crowd here in Gananoque. All the way around the boards and the sides. Absolutely punched here at the Loop. Nothing changed up on the board yet. Blasco gonna come in for this faceoff. Face off one, hook there, a little bit on Higgs, but Gananoque is able to get it, send it all the way down in. Grabbed up quick, chipped in behind the net. As they'll chase it down, the Rockets get it up to the blue line and out. As it'll be chased down by Blasco, who will grab it up in his zone. Cutting across from his net, drops the pass off. As Gann has some time here. 3:04 remaining on the penalty for 4 minutes. So Gann, they can get one here in the next 56 seconds. We'll still have a power play remaining at the end of it. Shot, and a good tip there, but a banger save. But a grab right back up by Selick as he sticks with it, and Gananoque keeps possession in the offensive zone. Domingo has it down low, back up to Domingo. Back to the point, shot coming from ground, and then it's sent all the way down the ice as it'll be stopped up by Hertz, who will stop it and then flick it out to Domingo, who has to get onto it quick as Brown didn't notice the pass out as he was curling beside the net. Good hard hit there on Selick. Puck makes it across, so drive through. Verbeek shot, and Verbeek scores to give Gann a 7-3 lead, and they're going to continue with 2 minutes on the power play. And now we have fans starting to get at each other. This is a common occurrence here in the USHL in Gananoque, where the fans and players all get into it with each other. Now we have another fan starting to argue with the crowd, as they need to get barriers in here in Gananoque to keep people apart. Grabbed up behind the net. Latimer has it, drives out, chips it up to Mercier. Mercier coming in. You can't get that one through. Sorry, a little bit of commotion here going on behind me as fans are trying to keep a North Dundas Rockets fan from going over to the Gananoque section to initiate, which I believe from what I'm hearing is a fight with a female, which is never good when a male wants to fight a female at a hockey game. Needs to get some control. Maybe the Islanders will have to bring the Gananoque PD out to get some control in these arenas, as the fans don't seem to be able to control themselves. drive in, doesn't get taken up as it gets grabbed up by Gann. Verbeek will backtrack in, grabs up behind his net as he goes to avoid McNamee, flips it over to the far side as they chip it up. North Dundas turns it over as they're able to get it through. Now here comes a drive on his feet. Walsh tries to center it, couldn't get that through. Now Giannakwe has it. Here comes a drive. Verbeek looking, sends it back, but it got intercepted by Moores. I don't think he noticed him there. And it'll get sent over around the board, all the way out, down into Giannakwe's zone. He'll get stopped up by Hertz behind his net and grabbed up by Reese, who will stop there, holding up. 9:50 remaining here in the third period of play. And they are able to drive it out of the zone. Sent in by Higgs. Quick onto it is Smith. Couldn't get to it as they send it out. 20 seconds remaining on the penalty. As it gets left up here. Now quick drive coming through. Wiley gets it in. Tries to chase it down. Can't get to it as they didn't have numbers. It comes out onto the Rocket stick. Chipped up to the neutral zone, but they'll get turned back by Reese and they'll drive it up. Here comes Giannakwe in over the blue line, centering an opportunity shot. And Jenkins got a piece of that one, sending it off to the far boards here. And a big hit by Williams on Wiley. As now the Rock is driving in, ship and a shot. Good save there made by Hertz, stopping the play. What an entertaining game this has turned out to be here in Giannakwe for the finals, game two. Anything is possible to come out of this game in the final, 8:57. But Giannakwe holding on to a strong, strong four-goal lead against the dominant North Dundas Rockets. Chipped up, drives out, trying to get that puck forward, can't get it. And it's turned back over and be sent in deep as they'll give it chase. You can see Duchesne is back. So Duchesne only received, I believe, a 10-minute misconduct, not a game misconduct. Was able to come back in after a wait. Now here comes a drive by Higgs to the net. In front, makes a good move. Can't get that one to go through. Almost, though, as he was able to get by the defender, does not tuck it by Jenkins. Onto the stick of Mott, sent up to the blue line, chipped out. Now here comes a drive, sent in, tried to chip it by, but a good play there. By Hertz, gets that one over to the corner. The pinch off the Rockets player over in the corner. As Duchesne continuing to engage, as I think he wants a piece here of the Rockets player, but can't get him to engage. Gann still continuing to move it forward though. Here it comes. Opportunity saved off of Stevens, centering pass by Jenkins. Stevens still sticking with it behind the net. Tries to center it to Mercier. Mercier picks that puck up, dealing with this active stick though of the Rockets. Keeps it from in Gann's possession. Now they're going to battle there at the blue line, chipped up into the neutral zone. And it gets sent all the way back down in as Dixon grabs up behind the net, dealing with the pressure of the Rockets to attack. They're able to turn it over at the blue line. Opportunity coming, but they try to center it. Broken up by Latimer. Verbeek comes in. Body's falling down there as Latimer gets that puck out. Takes a little bump, able to get it. Now here's an opportunity as Giannakwe driving in. Sends it over. Palakowski centers to Verbeek, and a big save made by Jenkins. As that one sent in, Verbeek fires it back around to Palakowski. Palakowski to Verbeek, sends back in just wide of the net, over to Walsh. Walsh has to dodge Selick, and Selick comes out with the puck, centers it. Can't get that one to settle down to Verbeek as it hit Palakowski's stick and chipped up. Now into deep behind the net. There'll be a race here for the puck as Selick comes in to get in on that. Has Palakowski coming in for support. It's being dug at 6:40 remaining. Onto the stick of Moores. Moores comes through. Tries to beat the D's. Not alone. Chips it in the corner. Bumped in with Wiley. Wiley battling with him. Reese coming in to give some support with Bouchard. As it comes out onto the stick of Palakowski, who chips it over to Bouchard. Bouchard coming in. Shot. And that one saved up by Jenkins. Goes off over to the sideboards. And they're going to try to fire it out of the zone and ends up going up and out of play. And that will be inside the zone to the right of Jenkins. Bouchard is going to come in across from Stitz. One back to the point. Shot by Brown. Almost dialed in. Just misses. Sent in. Kicked by the Rockets player. And that one's going to get cleared out. Little rub out there by the Islanders player. Shot in. Glove saved by Hertz. Lost the puck, though. Picked up by Gann. Sent back to the point. Hit a leg. Goes off to the far corner. As Kota chasing it down. Gets by him. Comes in behind the net. Picked up by Brown. A little bit of shenanigans behind the play. You can hear screaming and profanities coming out of the fans. They say, I expect this game to explode here. It might be in the stands, though. Good block there with the trapper by Jenkins to keep that one from going through. Now here comes a drive in. Stopped up, looking, passer, shot. And that one couldn't get the rebound connected with as they sent it right back in. Latimer in behind the net using his body, trying to get that puck off. Not alone, has Higgs down there with him. They curl back to the point, misses, as it's going to come all the way back to the blue line. D, though, back playing defensively, able to grab that, chips it forward, as they're going to try to drive it in, but a turnover here to Gianacque, mishandled. It comes all the way back down to Gianacque's own. 4:47 remaining here, as Gianacque turning in. They have a 4-goal lead, looks to be enough, that's probably going to finish this game out, but you never know against this high-powered North Dundas Rocket. Mishandled there in front of the net. Scramble. They couldn't get a piece of it. Four, 32 remaining here in the third period. 36 shots for Gianacque. 28 for the Rockets. Gianacque holding on to a 7-3 lead. There's been excitement of all sorts here. Other than having the mitts actually drop, they have been full of excitement. Players getting tossed, hits, goals, saves, arguments with referees, players, fans, fans wanting to fight fans. What a game this has turned out to be here in Gianacque. Face off in the feet, comes out on the Rocket stick, stopped up behind their net. Turn back to the side board, far boards. They're going to drive it up to the blue line. Salek giving him the business. Can't get the puck off him. Now Palkowski. That gets chipped in deep. Quick onto it will be Wiley. Gets that puck up. Carrying it to this close side. Chips it along the boards. As he gets sent up. Now here comes the drive for Bubik. Shot up high. Save made by Jenkins. Rebound. Shot in. Jenkins pulls off his helmet. As that one got him up high. And the crowd giving a boo. As Jenkins let it go off. Fans for Gann feel it was pulled off purposely. North Dundas fans defending their goalie. Anything more heat in the stands today than on the ice with the way this one's going, I might want to make sure I have my camera ready to go. 4:05 remaining. Jenkins, helmet's back on, set back to go. He looks a little worse for wear. Verbeek's going to start this face-off off. One over the sideboard. Selleck gets it, shoves it in, gets pinched off. That puck will come around into the corner. Quick onto his Palakowski, tries to get back, can't, but gets turned over to Selleck, who now is going to battle along these close boards with the puck. Has some pressure, but still holding it. Sends it up to the blue line. Verbeek had that chip off his stick. Otherwise, they would have had a two-man driving in. Good little bump there, by Wiley. And that one sent out of the zone, or out of the play, onto the Gianacque bench. Just at Mr. Truesdell. Center ice will be the face-off. Rockets holding a short bench here late in this game as they've had three players ejected. Definitely the Rockets players not happy with the officiating in this game. Gianacque has had some arguments as well, so question here from both clubs as they are not very pleased with the officiating, and this game has been quite full of entertainment and, like I said earlier, shenanigans. Puck goes off over into the corner, quick under to Wiley. trying to deal with the attack, gets turned towards the net, still laying there in the corner while they get back on it, has Hare with him, trying to get it. Now on the sideboards again, Hockway, they're able to carry it out of the zone. Sent in deep is Harris. They go around to the far side. Getting Hockway quick on it with Stevens, trying to get it, but he chipped off his stick. Glasgow tried to get to him, couldn't. Then back to Harris, shot in, bounced up in the air. As easily cleared out by the Rockets. Trying to do a drive here. It was McNamee. He has two. Looking for the hat trick. Big save made by Hertz as they turn it back to Stevens. Now out of the zone. Comes Harris trying to chip it up. Stopped up at the blue line. Has a high stick up into Stevens' face. Goes missed by the officials. You can hear the fans not happy about that. We apologize, we don't have a way to bleep out any inappropriate language. Here comes Coda coming in, looking. Shot! Save made by Jenkins. Onto the stick, quick. Up again, our player turned in front of the net, but couldn't get it as it chipped off to the corner. Burchard can't get it. Smith couldn't get it. Onto the Rocket stick as they're going to carry it out into the neutral ice zone. Driving in with some speed. Trying to pull through is Krishnarik. Pinched off behind the boards. Shot from the slot, save made by Hertz. They try to send it across, can't get it. As they'll be quick under it. Will be Kota, who whacks it out of the zone. As we come down to the final 2 minutes of play, hard shot onto Hertz, just left there. As Gianacqua driving down, and with a man 42, this game all but over, other than maybe some final shenanigans. Puck cleared all the way out into around the Gianacqua bench, turned back the other way by the changing players. Lots of hollering on both sides. No one could get a call either way for too many men, though, as now here comes the Rockets back the other way. Coming in is Mott. Mott looking, shot. Save made by Hertz. Over to the far side. Picked up. I believe that is Mercier coming in over the blue line. Tries to cut by the D, can't get by it. Trailing Gianacqua player Harris sent it in. But had to wait to tag up as Gianacqua is offside. Cut through. Here comes Morris. Looking through. Cuts into the slot. Shot. Hit a leg. Rebound shot. Just up and over the net. As it goes in behind, they're going to try to get it forward. Can't. Hertz chips it back to D. He doesn't mind playing this up. Mercy blows a tire. Wiley gets tripped. Still bowing for that puck. Back to the point. Gets cleared out. 40 seconds remaining. Puck left in behind the net. Looks like this game should make it out here without any more issues, but we'll see what happens in this final 30 seconds. Hard shot in. Byers comes out to their side. Under quick was Wiley. Sends it back to the point. They chip it back right into the corner. Trying to center an opportunity. Can't get it. Comes out the sideboard. Back to the point. Shot coming in. Chip just in front of the net. Wide as it's picked up by Wiley. Wiley gets it chipped to the corner on Dakota stick. Dakota trying to hold off on the boards. Sends it back in by the net to Reese. Reese chips around the boards. Final seconds. That one's going to go all the way down the ice. And Jenkins will leave it. This is the final 2 seconds. Gianacqua seals the deal. Taking game two. 7-3. Tying the series up at one game apiece, forcing a game four here in Gianacqua next Saturday. And here are the three stars. Mike McNamee with the third star. Well, we hope you enjoyed the game again. Amazing game, entertaining. There was everything you could ask for. Hits, there was scrums, no real fights, but there was scrums, there was big saves, there were highlight goals, and there's a lot of shenanigans in the stands. A lot. It was a fun game. We enjoyed it. So game goes back to Chesterfield, I believe they said, for Thursday, and then back here in Gianacqua, 3 p.m. on Saturday. I'll be here for that game in Gianacqua. We'll be covering that. Gianacqua, now tied up, has a chance to look at winning their first USHL championship. We'll see what happens. We hope you enjoyed the game. Thank you very much for tuning in. tuning in, keep an eye on Ballers of Hockey Nation. Might be able to grab some highlights from this game, but we're going to be trying to bring you more coverage. We're going to be also doing some Red Hats for the next two weekends upcoming when we get some content for them, and Championship Weekend and Provincials for the U22 Elite for the girls team in Kingston. So keep an eye on that. Ballers of Hockey Nation trying to bring you as much content as possible here in the U Sports and a little senior sport too. Hope you enjoyed the broadcast. See you guys.